My name is Jordan Melagrana, and my project is called The Accused. It's a board game that's meant to simulate the experience of the criminal justice system here in America for people with not very much money. In real life, the criminal justice system is not a game, but it is a system that is rigged against people with not a lot of money. It is not really based on justice. It is based a lot on luck and chance. You can have two people accused of a very similar crime under very similar circumstances, and they can have drastically different experiences in our system. In the case of public defenders, I found this to be very true. I became aware of situations in states like Missouri and Louisiana where the state had defunded the public defender's office to such an extent that attorneys were not available for indigent clients, clients who couldn't afford an attorney on their own, when they would get caught in the system. So this resulted in people sitting in jail for days or weeks or even months just waiting for a lawyer. And in some cases, the folks sitting in jail had been arrested for crimes that even if they had been sentenced to the max, it would be less time than they spent just waiting for an attorney to go to trial. But to get people to understand that, they need to understand what is bail, what is pretrial detention, how does the system work? For a lot of folks, the criminal justice system is what you see on TV. It's in Law and Order, it's in CSI, it's in all those places. And not enough of the people we needed to convince that reform is necessary really understood the system. So before I can even get to the point of making the argument I want to make, I feel like there's a lot of gaps to fill in. So I had considered a couple of different things. I'm a filmmaker, and so I thought maybe putting together a video or two might be the way to go. But I really didn't want it to be distant. I didn't want people to watch a story kind of from afar. In this case, I wanted to do the best I could to simulate the experience, and the best way I could think of doing that is to create a board game where someone plays as if they have been accused of a crime, and so that their success in the game depends upon luck and all these things that people face in real life. The game is structured like a board game, similar to the game of life or Monopoly. You start at one end and your goal is to make it from the upper corner to the lower corner. You're working your way all the way through the system. So your bail is set for the crime that you've been accused of. You spend time in jail before you go to trial. You're offered plea bargains by the prosecutor. Ultimately, you can choose to take the plea bargain or go to trial. And at trial, you can either be found guilty or not guilty. If you're found guilty, you proceed and serve your prison time. Then as you exit the prison system, you enter the probation or parole system. And finally, if you're lucky, you do eventually exit the system, and that is how you win the game. So what makes the game difficult is that it's not simply a start and a finish and you proceed no matter what. At many points along the way, other things can happen to you that actually send you all the way back to the beginning. While you're in prison, you can be accused of another crime and start the process all over again. Even once you've gotten out of prison and you're on probation, it is extremely easy to violate your probation for things like you missed the bus and you missed your probation officer's meeting. People rolled the dice to see what would happen to them at trial. They would take a random card to see what decision a prosecutor or a defense attorney made. The public defender piece is really important because throughout the entire game, the only thing that really helps a player is what a public defender can do for them. So you would get a card and maybe it would say the public defender has successfully argued to reduce your sentence, which is a great thing and really helps you out in the game. But then some of the public defender cards actually talk about these situations that are happening in some of these states. And so a public defender card might say, the state has defunded the public defender's office. You now must wait X amount of turns until an attorney becomes available. Much like real life, getting out of the system is not as straightforward as it might appear. So on presentation day, I invited classmates to come and sit and start actually just playing the game. What I found really interesting and what really broadened my horizons a bit with this was the human interaction while playing the game and the moments available for education through playing the game. There were a lot of opportunities for me to explain a few things, and people, I think, learned a little bit more about the system than they did when they first started playing. But even better than that were the people who had been in the criminal justice system themselves, and they spoke up, and they were able to sort of teach the rest of the class what this is all about, what it's like to go through it, the frustrations, the lack of support. And that was the part that I really enjoyed, and the part that really kind of taught me how valuable the game could be. I do believe it's just the tip of the iceberg. There are so many things that came up through the gameplay that I felt need even more explaining and even more important that we get it out to the American public. And so I feel like The Accused can be an important tool for advocates and educators and just people to learn about the system that affects all of us.